This video is about epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is one of the type of the tissue. In epithelial tissues, the same type of cells are closely packed together to form a group of cells. They form the thin lining known as the epithelial tissue. So these cells are closely packed together. They have very less intracellular spaces between these cells, and inside these spaces, the amount of the matrix is also very less. So according to the structure of the epithelial tissue, they perform the specific functions. As epithelial tissues form the thin lining, so they are involved in the provides the boundaries and covering to the body surfaces. So it provides the outermost covering to the body and also provides the lining to the internal organs of the body. So according to the shape, size, and function, the epithelial tissue are classified into different types. They are classified on the basis of layer, on the basis of number of layers, and also on the basis of the shape of the epithelial cells. So epithelial tissues are classified on the basis of number of layers. They are the simple epithelial tissues. And in the simple epithelial tissues, it is composed of the single layer of one single layer of the cells, that these are closely packed together and to form the one single layer of cells. So they are known as simple epithelial tissues. When there are the group of cells are arranged in a more than one layer of cells, when there are more than one layer of cells, they are known as stratified epithelial tissues. So in stratified epithelial tissues, these cells are closely packed together in a more than one layer of cells. So they are known as stratified epithelium. In stratified epithelium, the new cells originate from the origin, and then these pushes the other cells, older cells, to the upper side, and then these cells, when they get mature, they are removed from the upper area, from the upper side. So they are composed of the on the basis of the layer of cells, they are the simple epithelial tissues and stratified epithelial tissues. So simple epithelial tissues, they are composed of the single layer of cells, and stratified epithelial tissues, they are composed of more than one layer of cells, group of cells. So now, on the basis, these simple epithelium, again, these simple and stratified epithelium are classified on the basis of the shape. So these shape are gives the according to the function and according to the lining of the different organs. So simple epithelial tissue, as it is composed of the single layer of cells. So single layer of cells is basically that it is provides the covering and lining. So the diffusion, the process of diffusion can easily take place through it, and even the mostly material and substances that are coming to the body, or they have to pass through the simple epithelial tissue. So simple epithelial tissue are then further classified into three types on the basis of the shape and function. So simple epithelial tissues are classified into different types. They are the simple squamous epithelium. So simple means that it is composed of the single layer of cells. Squamous epithelium, these are the epithelial tissues, but of the squamous type. So these cells are basically the shape, the name is given according to the shape of the cell. So these are the squamous epithelial cells that form the single layer of cells and are closely packed together. So they are the very thin layer. So these simple squamous epithelium, they, according to their function, they line the different organs of the human body. So which organs it lines the human body? Simple squamous epithelium, it basically provides the lining to the heart, where it is known as endocardium. So this simple squamous epithelium, when it lines the heart, then there it is known as endocardium, and also lines the blood vessels and lymph vessels, where it is known as endothelium. The simple squamous epithelium also lines the alveoli of the lungs, and also lines the collecting ducts of nephrons in the kidneys. So these cells are fit closely together, like they form a very thin layer across which the diffusion can easily take place. So other type of tissue simple epithelium tissue is the simple cuboidal epithelium. So this is also the simple epithelial tissue that is composed of single layer of cells, but these cells are cuboidal. So these are the cube-shaped cells that are fitting closely together to form the single layer of cube-shaped cells. So these cells, basically, it provides the lining to the kidney tubules, and they also provide the lining to the thyroid. So these tissues basically line these organs like kidney tubules and thyroid, where they are responsible and where they are involved in the functions. Most specifically, they are involved in the secretion and the absorption, or they are also involved in excretion. So in these organs, the simple cuboidal epithelium is involved in the secretion, absorption, or excretion processes. The other type of the simple epithelial tissue is the simple columnar epithelium. So they are also the simple epithelial tissue, but they are columnar in shape. So these cells are the single layer of cells, but they are columnar in shape. So it means that they are rectangular in shape. So this simple columnar epithelium, there is one property for the simple columnar epithelium, that they have different adaptations to different organs. Like in the stomach, it is present as a simple columnar epithelium, and where it is involved in the different processes, that it provides the lining to the stomach wall, and then it also provides the lining to the small intestine. So in the small intestine, it is involved in the formation of the microvilli. So in the microvilli, where it is involved in the absorption processes. Then it is also involved, the simple columnar epithelium also lines the respiratory tract. So in the respiratory tract, most specifically in the trachea, they provide, like this simple columnar epithelium inside the respiratory tract, they are ciliated. They have the cilia. So the cilia are basically involved in when the foreign substances or the inhaled particles, they enter into the respiratory system, then they are involved, the ciliated columnar epithelium, they are involved in the movement of that inhaled particle toward the throat by the cilia. So they remove the foreign particles or the inhaled particles are projected towards the respiratory tract, or they are projected towards the other main type of epithelium tissue are the stratified epithelial tissue. They are made up of the multiple layer of cells, like the more than one layer of cells. So stratified epithelium are also classified into simple squamous epithelium. They are also divided into, on the basis of the shape, into squamous, cuboidal, columnar, and translational. So simple stratified squamous epithelium, they are stratified because they are having the multiple layer of cells, and squamous because they are the squamous in shape. So stratified squamous epithelium, that they are the number of layer of cells stacked to each other, they provide the lining to the esophagus and mouth. So these types of lining or the tissues lines these organs, so they provide the protection to these organs. The other stratified epithelial tissue is the stratified columnar epithelium. They are also involved in the columnar, like they are the column. They are the columnar type cells, rectangular type cells, but multiple in layer. So they provide the lining, or they cover the glands. They are mostly involved in the covering and lining of the. They're involved in the formation of the glands. So they are the sweat glands, salivary glands, and mammary glands. So this type of epithelium, or this type of lining, is involved, basically involved in the process of secretion. So they are involved in the secretions through the sweat glands, through salivary glands, and through mammary glands. So these glands are basically involved in the secretion. Secretory, these have the secretory processes. The other type of the stratified epithelium is the stratified cuboidal epithelium. So there are also the multiple layer of the cube-shaped cells. These provide the linings to the main urethra and some other glands of the body. So they also provide the protection to these glands. The other type of the stratified columnar epithelium is the stratified translational epithelium. So stratified translational epithelium, they are the pear-shaped cells. As they are the pear-shaped cells, it lines the several parts of the urinary tract, including the bladder, and allows for stretching as the bladder fills. So they are known as stratified because they are multiple layers, and they are known as transitional because their shape changes from one shape to the other shape, as they are in the form of columnar when they are relaxed, like they are lining of the urinary bladder. So during urination processes, they are from the relaxed, from the stretch form, they are become relaxed. So in the stretch form, they are in the form of squamous type, in the, and then when they are relaxed, they become the columnar. So these are transition that they changes from the shape changes from the squamous to columnar and from columnar to squamous depends on the process of the urination. So they basically lines the urinary bladder. So collectively, these different types of epithelial tissues, as the epithelial tissues are divided on the basis of number of layers, they are divided into simple epithelial tissues and stratified epithelial tissues. So the simple epithelial tissues further divided into different types on the basis of the shape, like squamous, cuboidal, and columnar epithelium. And same like the stratified into squamous, stratified squamous, cuboidal, columnar, and the transitional epithelium. So what are the collective functions of these epithelial tissues? What are the functions of epithelial tissues? So epithelial tissues, as collectively, if we see that they provide the protection, as we saw in this video, that protection is provided to which organs? Like the most common example is the ciliated columnar epithelium, that it provides the protection to the respiratory system or to the lungs, that the, if there is any foreign substances are inhaled by the human body, they are projected outwards to through the projection of the cilia, that they're stuck to the these ciliated columnar epithelium, that they secrete the mucus, and this mucus, and then through the formation of the cilia, they are projected towards the outside, and they protect the lungs from the foreign inhaled particles. The other function of the epithelial tissue are the secretions. So secretions, as we saw, that they these epithelial tissue forms the lining and involved in the formation of different types of glands. So these glands are responsible for the secretion, as the sweat gland, they are involved in the secretion, and then the salivary glands are involved in the formation of the, that they secrete different substances, that different mucus secretions. The other example of the the other function of the epithelial tissue are the absorption. As the example of the absorption, that it lines the small intestine. The small intestine lining is made up of the simple columnar epithelium, and these simple columnar epithelium are involved in the formation of the microvilli, and these microvilli provide the large surface area for the absorption of different nutrients from the small intestine.